Welcome to the Joe Wiley Sessions on Sky Arts. Tonight's music comes from a four-piece who were plucked from obscurity to play the festival while still at school. Now musically mature and onto album number three, please welcome Bombay Bicycle Club. One step back, you leaving. Now it's moving on. Why won't you believe in it till it's gone? Our headliners this evening have recently taken their high-octane live performances to the States for the very first time. Now back on home soil with the first single from their acclaimed third album, here's Bombay Bicycle Club with Shuffle.
club.avi. Basically, this was when we were 16. We hadn't even been a band for very long. Jamie entered us into this competition. I don't think he even told the rest of us. So it was a bit of a surprise when we randomly got a message on MySpace one day saying we're through to the final of this competition. So we played this gig at Islington Academy, ended up opening the second stage of V Festival, which at the time was like the most amazing thing. Nice, obviously we'd never played a festival before. No, it was a good weekend.
Thank you. I think it's important to have influences from different genres because it stops people's music becoming stagnant. In our first album, we were very influenced by kind of guitar music and like early 90s indie bands, kind of like Pavement or Dinosaur Jr. And then on our second album, it's very different from that. And we were influenced by kind of 70s folk artists, which is hugely different. I don't think many bands would make a change like that. On this album, there's a lot of influences from hip-hop and just electronic music as opposed to guitar music. So I don't know, I think it just keeps things refreshing, like makes them new and exciting.
Time for a break, but keep it right here on the Joe Wiley Sessions as we return with more Bombay Bicycle Club. Welcome back to the Joe Wiley Sessions on Sky Arts with the North London's Bombay Bicycle Club. More at home with wild stage invasions. Here, they're in rather more sedate surroundings with still.
Had your standards close to harbour late one night, you threw them down. Simple promises you said you'd never break, but now you have. All throughout the morning, though I'm begging, no, your lips, they stay perfectly.
I think the most unusual gig we played was down a mine shaft in Devon. It was actually part of a tour of unusual gigs, but I think this one in particular stood out because we were also sort of dressed in Victorian clothing. I think I may have been a woman though, like a washerwoman or something.
And there wasn't actually an audience in the mine shaft. It was just a camera and us. It was quite scary, actually. It's something I'd like to do again, definitely.
There's a story in which my eyes shut. Would you back me up? Would you back me up? Would you back me up? Would you back me up?
I think this record's a bit more electronic because I was just listening to a lot of stuff that's coming out now, like Joy Orbison, Mount Kimby, James Blake.
There's a limit to your love, like a waterfall in slow.
Other stuff from America, like Flying Lotus, Washed Out. And I was making a lot of music just separate from the band, like in the more electronic music. That kind of just spilled over into the band naturally, I think. The music that I started to make in this genre, I thought would be interesting if I tried and make it more guitar-based and make more sense within the band and see if it worked.
So carelessly there, is it truth or care? There's a limit to your care.